Excuse me, ma'am, I had you on this.
What did she say?
Everything. Like, I hate wasted potential. That shit crushes your spirit. It really does. It crushes your soul.
Guys, I am back with another YouTube video. I recorded 3 videos, but they did not go to plan at all. For one, the makeup, it was just not going well, the first time. The second time, I was talking about social media and I felt like I got too into it, even though I love the makeup look, but I felt like I was just too, you know, I don't really want to do that. I don't really want to do things like that. Where I'm so serious about, I want to make the situation like lighthearted, and I felt like I was a bit too. And then there was a third video. I can't remember what that was, to be honest. Did I even film a third video? I don't know. But anyway, today I am doing a little Miss Ariana Grande look with the hair as well, and also with the makeup because she released Positions and it's a bop. So yeah, I really wanted to do it and I feel like it's very on trend with what everyone's doing, so I'm a bit of a sheep. He's shown a sheep. But yeah, so I hope you guys like this video. I did more focusing on the eyes, and then the face and everything, I just told you what I used, and we got into some stuff like icks, Roadman aesthetic, and I forgot what else I got into. It's been a long day with Little Miss technical issues, but like I said, it's my video, so when don't we deal with technical issues? But yeah, hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'm gonna stop talking. Enjoy the video. I'm sweating like a motherfucker. So anyway, as you can see, I have done one eye off camera, and can I just say, I should have made it more like this, but I didn't, like in the picture. So this is, you know, it's suiting my eye. So if you have a problem with that, you should get out of my business, because you in my business.
You in my business? You in my business?
I used the 16 hour camo matte concealer by e.l.f. because I feel like, and I find that the more they use it, the less that you have in here, it dries down quite quick and it becomes very matte. Well, not very matte, but matte in itself. So I find it a lot better on my eye, because if you don't know, well, you should know, because you're a person, your body. This is your whole body. Because you are not a rat on a highway.
Like a rat on the highway.
You're a person. You know, your eyelids be oily, so I find that it works better. Obviously, use an eye primer, but I don't have one with me. Actually, I do, but it's out of date. So mind your business with that too. So we're gonna use Beauty Bay Fiery Palette, 16 color palette. It's so pretty, looks like this. But I set my eyes with this shade here. This one's called Peaches and Cream. It's actually this shade. So it's more of like a skin tone, like yellowy type of color. So we are now gonna be using the shade Honey Roast, which is this really beautiful sandstone type of shade. And I'm just going back and forth, and I'm just kind of flicking it, kind of making a cut crease. I'm just using this on a fluffy brush on my hair and form. You know, there was so much that I had to say in my last video, which you will probably never see. Let me just tell you something about me. Let me tell you about me. I, as biased as it sounds, I am quite a, what I like to call myself, I like to think of myself as quite an alpha. Opinionated, yeah, you could say that. If I have a problem, yeah, know about it.
Period.
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 My mouth don't say it, my face will. So I'm very, so I felt like I was a bit too, and then literally a few days later something happened that I saw, and I was a bit like, but I was just like, Janelle, breathe, you know, just breathe. Just breathe. Also, I just cleaned it up using like a clean, like fluffy brush. And I'm gonna go in the shade with, this video, I'm gonna put you on. Even though I like everything that I use in this video, certain things I'm gonna put you on. So I'm using the show Chocolate Souffle, and me and Chocolate, let me tell you about me and Chocolate Souffle. We're like, it's this very beautiful chocolate brown, if you didn't get it by the name. But with this shade, oh, she's stunning. She's amazing. She's beautiful. She's
show-stopping, spectacular, never the same, totally unique.
She's all of those things. You just want to be making like lines, like just sketching it out. You know how you have your crease, like, but you just want to put the brown shade just a little bit above it. And I'm just literally softly sketching where I want it to go. And it's okay if it's not like perfect, because as long as you've got the rough outline, you're cool, baby. Just perfect that line just by going over it. So, just to blend out this bit, I'm just gonna take this little Spectrum mini like fluffy brush, and then I'm gonna go in the shade into Caramel Sauce. And it's such a beautiful shade. Like, it has a little bit of like gold shimmer in it, but it's not like glitter or anything, and literally it blends out like a dream. And I'm literally just blending it over the chocolate souffle color that we lay down, and I'm just gonna bring it down here a bit. And if you find that, you know, that you're losing a bit of that colour from Chocolate Souffle, then just, by all means, just go back in with it. And just to blend out that edge, I'm just going in with, oh my god, my little baby hairs. Honey Roast, just a little bit on top of it. I go on top with like a clean brush as well. Back in with Miss Chocolate Souffle. So I'm happy with how that looks. What I quite like about this is literally like just rough sketching and just buffing it out. Like, it doesn't have to be perfect at all. So I'm going back in with that e.l.f. concealer and just using the smallest amount on this little Spectrum brush. I'm just packing on that product. And I'm just gliding it carefully underneath that line. Because it dries down quick, like, you don't have to worry about the product running everywhere, because sometimes when you use like concealer on your eyes and stuff, it can do a little imprint. Did it do an imprint? No. And I feel like you have more control of it, of where it goes on the eyes. To get into this little corner here, I'm just using this angled Spectrum brush, placing the product onto that, and I'm just mapping it out and lightly filling as I go. And once I'm happy with that, I am gonna, this is such an old brush. I think this was the first proper makeup brush that I bought, which is from Sleek. And I'm using the shade Peaches and Cream. And I'm lightly just tapping that shade all over. So I just did a little bit of corrective work on this eye. So yes. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna quickly put on my mascara and my lashes. Where are my lashes? Who lives in the pineapple under the sea? SpongeBob SquarePants. Anyway, so my lashes are on. So anyway, we're gonna move on to Fierce. So I love this product. You've seen me use in my last one, and if you didn't, link in the bio, because I'm only here to promote myself and products that I use. So who gon' check me? Who gon' check me?
Who gon' check me? Who gon' check me? Exactly.
Bye. Bye. I'm gonna use the Miss Fenty. Ah, shit, my brushes are over there. So we're just gonna doop, doop, and doop. I would use a brush, but I'm not gonna, as you can clearly see. So I've been seeing so many videos at the moment where it's like talking about the ick. So why not talk about it? I'll tell you one that was so common. It was boys with long nails.
You is nasty!
I remember when I first arrived into the Philippines, like when I was like 11, like to live over there properly. One of my uncles had like a really fuck off long ass nail and I was just like, what the fuck? I thought it was just a Filipino thing, but no, I think it's an all male thing and I just don't get it. It's another thing that gives me the ick. It's actually more of a pet peeve than an ick. And me and Shanae, hey girl, we're gonna be talking about it more in a little series we're gonna do. But one thing I hate, why are you following me and you're not liking any of my pictures? Did you just come here for an extra follower, honey? Because if you did, that's... the door's over there. With me, I browse on Insta. If I like something, then I like it and stuff. And sometimes I just like it just for the sake of liking it. And also, I'm just showing my support. But some of you bitches don't want to like shit. And I'm just like, bruv, like, is there so much pride in not, like... liking someone's picture, but you have the audacity to watch my stories. I see you.
Well,
as Miss Jackie Aina would say, you're a silent ass ninja. We don't like silent ass ninjas. But also, guys, Christmas is coming. So I had a very exciting parcel today, and it was from Little Miss Sisters and Seekers. And I feel like they're such an unknown brand, but they're known. And so like they had, thank God to Black Friday, that's all I'm saying, because the discount, I don't think they've ever done like a discount like that. It's very, very, very rare that Sisters and Seekers do a discount, to be honest. So you know me, I had to snatch up and I got the most beautiful coat, because I'm not gonna lie, I fucking struggled to find a coat this year. I mean, usually with me, I'll have that, I'll have a bit of that. It's a bit of me, and nothing was speaking out to me until I went on Sisters and Seekers. And you know, and it's that annoying thing when you've already placed your order and then you see something and you're like,
precious.
That was me. And I was like, I don't need a coat. I've already said I don't need a coat. Basically, to summarize, I got a new coat. Got a new coat from Miss Sisters and Seekers. By the way, the concealer that I used was the Hydrating Elf one. And I'm just using the Hollybean powder in number 2 translucent. Also, this sheet is finely milled, by the way, and like it just matches my complexion when I'm not tanned really lovely, and it doesn't really give me that cakey appearance either because of how finely milled it is, because sometimes I'm like, bitch, my eyes feel like they're gonna drop off. So yeah, that's my review. Back to the whole Sisters and Seekers thing. I said on my Instagram, you guys better, you know, keep an eye out in 2021, specifically the new year, because let's just say new content is coming. I'm excited about it because, bitch, things are changing over here. Also, don't mind that I do my makeup in a different way that you're probably not used to doing, because I know how some people like to do loose powder or compact powder together, and then, you know, you do your powder, bronzer all over your face, and then you do your blush where you need to do. I do mine, it's like a jigsaw. It's a jigsaw, basically, so don't mind me. Also, I use the, oh my God, I'm losing everything. I used Little Miss Too Faced bronzer. And I'm just going in with the shade Orgasm. I was watching Molly Mae, because I love Molly Mae. I was watching her vlog, and I saw that she bought the same coat that I bought from Pretty Little Thing. And I'll insert a picture. Bitch, tell me why when she wears it, she's snatched. She looks good. Tell me when I bought it a month ago, I look like some marshmallow looking, licorice looking, high shine motherfucker. And I had to return it. I'm just like, wow. God has his favorites, huh? There's something about puffer coats that have a very special place in my heart. It is Rodman Couture. Everybody needs a puffer coat. And in the winter, oh my God, that is your saving grace. There's something about Rodman coats, yeah. Collectively, including puffer jackets. Rodman aesthetic, fashion wise, you know, you leave the rest of whatever they do to the side. We're talking about their fashion. I don't know. It's just a bit of me.
It's a bit of me.
It's just beautiful. From the tracksuits, from the different type of style puffers. You want a long one, you want a short one, you want a cropped one. You want some night trainers with it. And also a cap, not the Gucci caps or that, you know, the ones that people wear on, like the real, like it comes up to here. I don't understand that. Just pull it down. It's not that hard. I'll do it for you if you want. I'm not a big fan of the pouches. Pouches aren't for me. You couldn't get more British than that, darling. So we're gonna go and contour our nose. as well. I got this parcel from DHL and I was just like, bitch, what did I buy that I don't know about? And then I was like, oh my god, what if someone mysteriously sent me a package? Like, I don't know, future husband. Could have been Drake for all I care, you know? And I was like, oh my god, what if it's a secret admirer? But no, it was a parcel for my brother because literally there was no name on it. And my mum always assumes that it's me buying shit. I mean, she's not wrong. No, it wasn't me for once. So yeah, that was a bit disappointing today. Brush this powder off. I'm gonna put some mascara on my bottom lashes. I've got two video ideas that I cannot wait to put out. I think I'm gonna put out one for next week and one maybe the week after. Oh my god, as well, I was watching Mitchell's YouTube channel and I didn't even know he had a YouTube channel, and I was watching him decorate his, oh, I forgot how blinding this is. Hello. By the way, this is the Ofra Glow Up palette. I've had this for donkey years, man, and it's beautiful. I'm using the shade, a bit aggressive Ofra. You know, you have to match up the pan to how it looks on the back. Rodeo Drive, but I like to mix in, what is it called? Star Island. I didn't really need to do that, I just wanted to do it. That's quite bright. Oh well, with the Star of Bethlehem tonight, bitch. And literally, his office is goals. Like, my man rented the apartment next door to him for his makeup. That's bougie levels. But I need to try some of his makeup, like I really want to try it. And as I'm talking, which I shouldn't be because this is going to end up a disaster, but I'm using the Makeup Academy Intense Color Lip Liner in the shade Obsession now. I'm about to put you onto a lip combo. And literally, this combo I'm about to show you, it's the 90s look for me. It's the seamlessness for me. But anyway, I'm going to shut up and just apply the lip liner. Looks a bit crazy. My lips look like a booty hole. But this lip liner here, £1.50. It's literally like MAC. Compare MAC prices to £1.50. It glides on like a dream. It's creamy. It stays where it's supposed to stay. Need I say any more? £1.50. Thank me later. We are now gonna go on to Miss Fenty. I actually do have an itch. This was what I got in the set from my last video, but I just didn't wear it because I was wearing it. And this is in the shade Unbutton. Look at it. So what I'm gonna do. Now it looks messy and you're probably thinking, yeesh. But I'm gonna blend it with my finger. Trust the process. So it almost looks kind of like a powdered effect rather than like a liquid lipstick. My laptop needs to calm down. Now if you want, you can go back in with the Obsession lip liner. I think I'm gonna do a little bit of that. Literally, it's so pigmented, this liner. You need to do it in small doses. First things first, I curled my hair, if you can see. The Mark Hill curler. This is the pick and, excuse you, this is the pick and mix curler thing. So basically what it means by pick and mix is that there are interchangeable handles on this. So this is the new handle, which basically you just twist it so you don't have to break your arm whilst curling your hair. I don't really use the feature as much as I thought I would. But I think when I do my little spiral curls, like the little corkscrew ones, that's what I use. I think this is the medium. I'll put an asterisk in case I'm wrong. But yeah, so you just clip it in. And then there's a little button here, which so easily take off. But yeah, it just has one on and off switch and stuff like that. So that's what I use for that. You should heat protect your hair, but I don't. But I use the watch I've got to be glued. Blessing freeze spray for screaming hold. So yeah, cool classic, and can't go wrong with it. I prep my hair using that, and then I use the Denman. It's really gross.
Ew, scary.
Don't mind my little hairbrush. This is the Denman brushing out brush. Looks like this. This is the only brush that works for my hair. My hair is quite thick, and there's a lot of like body in it as well, so it can get knotted so easily and stuff like that. With the smallest thing, and because it's quite sharp bristles, it's the only thing that can untangle my hair as well, and it just gives me really nice like movement to the curls as well. So yeah, that's what I use. So I first spray my hair, and then I brush it out using this, so the whole spray is properly distributed. I just curl that. I use the technique of, you know, curling away from your hair like that, all around, and then I spray it with some more hairspray and whatnot. And with this hairstyle, because my hair is quite thick and whatnot, I don't want the curls to look as like brushed out, so I don't brush out any of the curls basically. So I just use this little pintail comb, and this I just find a parting and stuff like that. Wow, my scalp looks red. So now that I've got a parting, I always keep it to this side of my hair just because I find that it suits my face a lot better. You can do any side that you want to. And then I part the hair, like the front section. And because I have a bit more hair here, I just move that forward. And then I move the rest of my hair back. So with this section now, I just grasp it. And I'm just gonna, where are my clips? I'm just gonna section it off with a bobble. I would use a clip, but I don't know where I've just put them. Story of my life. So yeah, that's what it looks like. And then what I'm gonna do, oh, I just found my clip. So starting at the very top point of my ear, I'm just taking that pintail comb and just grabbing a section. I'm just gonna grab a little bit more, and I'm just scooping that up. So there's still hair at the back, and I'm just making sure that there's no other little hairs in that way. Just comb this bit out first and scoop it. Keep it like that. I'm just gonna spray it to make sure the little baby hairs and whatnot are kept down. And I use my hand to do that. You can use a brush if you want to. It's up to you, girl. And so with this section, I'm gonna use my thumb this time to gather it up, just so I can see where I need to part it. So I'm using that red tail comb again, pintail comb, whatever you want to use, or whatever you want to call it, just to get more of a defined section. So now that you have that, I'm just gonna brush out any of the bumps. There's a lot of bumps. I'm just gonna spray my hair. Just looking at my mirror for reference. Just gonna scoop it up and tie it with a hair tie or a barbell if you're in the UK, you know? And literally it looks like that. But I like height, not just in my ponytails, girl. And I'm just using another hair tie. Placed it not over the first one, but just on top of it, just to give it that height. And now I can remove this bobble. I'm just gonna do the same, where I'm tying the hair tie just on top of the bobble that I previously placed, so it gives it that height, you see. And I lightly comb any of the bits that are a bit, you know, razzle dazzled. And you can leave it like this with the hair bit down, but I'm gonna pin it back for today. So for this bit, I just grab that pintail comb and just like brush it down, and then just make sure all the hair is just in one area. And then I get some grips, bobby pins, whatever you want to call them, and literally I just pin it just on my ear. If it's a bit messy, it's okay, we're gonna grip the rest in place, as long as that bit's kind of like down and stuff and it's kind of like secured in the area that you want it to. And then I'm just using another grip to actually like secure it. I hope this is making sense. And I'm taking the other grip and I'm just crisscrossing it, if you can see. And that is literally how I just do it. And then just for extra security, I'm just crisscrossing two more. And yeah, I'm just gonna gather all my hair at the front. You can curl pieces again if you want to, but I'm pretty happy with how it looks. And yeah, this is literally the hair. That is literally what I do. I literally use this hairstyle like at least once a week. It's one of my favorite go-to hairstyles, to be honest. The first time I tried it, poor Shanae, my hair was so hairsprayed back. And I was literally like, I don't know what to do. So Shanae, bless her, got up a reference image. She was like, we're gonna do this. Thanks to Shanae, I now know how to do this hairstyle. But yeah, so this is the full Ariana Grande inspired positions and hairstyle that I did for you guys today. I hope you guys like this video, and I hope you guys enjoyed me waffling as per usual. I really like this look. So yes, thank you again guys for watching. If you did enjoy this video, then I don't even say that, so I don't know why I'm saying it, but you know what to do. Do what you want, you know. Thank you guys for watching this video. Please remain safe, and I hope you guys have a wonderful day wherever you are in the world. Yeah, I will see you guys in my next video.